the current pandemic is one in which we have vast amounts of sequence data, many thousand sequences of this particular virus, which allows us an almost unique opportunity to understand both how it is mutating and then what selection is doing on the virus itself as well. So what we found is that when you look at the profile of mutation, it is extraordinarily strange. And what we've discovered is, in fact, that while there are many possible mutations that could occur in this virus, mutation, unlike in us, is not really a random process. It looks as though we are mutating the virus. There are three groups who are trying to make a vaccine by taking the whole virus and tweaking it. And tweaking it in a way that makes the virus okay, but not brilliant. And what this research tells us is what you should do to make the virus okay, but not brilliant. If you actually wanted to make a less good version of the virus, what we should be doing is mimicking the mutational process by making a synthetic version of the virus. The strategy that we've come up with to attenuate it is to increase CpG and increase U, and that should make one that our system can see that the virus can't replicate very well, but it can replicate enough to be able to elicit an immune response. We're not vaccine biologists and we're not virologists, but we've teamed up with two groups from Edinburgh who are virologists and who know about these strategies to synthesize live attenuated vaccines. So the next step is actually to check the predictions that we've been making using synthetic constructs. That's so we can actually, now we have the technology now to be able to say, if this is the sequence that I want, we can go and make a virus or a bit of a virus that has exactly that sequence. So we can now test these predictions by having different versions of the virus and seeing in the lab whether they do actually work as we predicted they should work.